In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Lord, we come before you now in the presence, Lord, of the Trinity, in the presence of all that you are to us, all that we have experienced you to be. And we come, Lord, having an experience and an aspect of this world, an aspect of our existence here, which is that we are born, Lord, and we leave this earth. That this moment inevitably comes. But we come, Lord, to celebrate also the beauty that we have just sung about, that Noel, that Hein now, Lord, finds himself in a wonderful place, having been called home. And this understanding, this concept of home, Lord, and how you are our Father and how you have created a place for us, we thank you for it. We bring praise and honor to you now. While we mourn, while it is painful, Lord, and it hurts, but we come and we cling to your altar now, Lord, for a word. We come to be in fellowship with each other, with believers, Lord, with those who believe what we believe. And know, Lord, that you are present here now. So we thank you for your presence. We thank you for the comfort that you have given the family already. We thank you for the experiences of faith, the wonderful memories, Lord, the legacy of Hein, and how we can come here to celebrate that too. Please, Lord, be with us now here this morning. Allow that these may be unforgettable moments of peace, unforgettable moments, Lord, of acknowledging you, of remembering a life, Lord, well lived, of reflecting on a powerful legacy of family, Lord, and of love. And that we come here, Lord, and we want to emulate that. We want to be like you. We want to aspire, Lord, to move towards this likeness of Jesus Christ. And no one is perfect, Lord, but we celebrate when we are able to achieve aspects of it, when we are able to achieve and see these characteristics in each other. And so this continues to be our striving here, Lord. We come here to be better. We come here to be close to you. And we come here to be close to the family now, Lord, so that we together are able to say a farewell, that we are able to bring praise, honor, and thanks to you. And that, Lord, in everything, we are able to say your will be done. Please be with us. Grant us this peace now in these few moments. We ask this in your most holy namesake. Amen.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, bereaved family, the word for this funeral divine service is taken out of Proverbs 3, the verses 3 and 4. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, and so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man. Die woord uit Spreuke 3, die verse 3 en 4. Laat liefde en trou jou nie verlaat nie. Bind dit op jou hals. Skryf dit op die tafel van jou hart. Dan sal jy genade vind en 'n goeie insig in die oë van God en die mense. So ver. We'll have the choir. And then
thank you.
Thank you very much to the choir. I want to start, brothers and sisters, bereaved family, congregation, I want to start just by saying, Noel, I wasn't sending you into the beyond there, in the opening prayer there. I wasn't being prophetic there, my brother. But I do want to just say to you as the family, welcome to the altar. And it's not a... Noel was in the sacristy just before. Maybe that's where it came from, Noel. And we prayed together. And part of the prayer in the sacristy was that we knew this day was coming. On a number of levels, we know that for us this day will come too. In Hein's life, there was a period where one then would anticipate this and say, you know, and you brace yourself for it. And now the day has come. And that day is here now, and it is not something we would have chosen. It is not something we would have wanted. But I want to say, don't let any moment in this day pass you by. Don't ignore it. Don't lean away from it. Lean into it. This is also an experience of God's grace. This is also an experience of God's love. That we are able to come and say farewell. That we are able to ask for a blessing onto Hein's life, onto this fellowship, onto this family. And that we come and we do that. We come and we do that together. And I want to say, the word that I have in my mind, Sally, is unforgettable. If I asked you, how was this week? Unforgettable. If I must ask you, how was your marriage? Unforgettable. If I must ask you, how was this smile? He's got a good set of teeth. You can see on the pamphlet here, good genes from his family. Unforgettable. An unforgettable presence that everyone that would come into your home, Sally, everyone that would interact with you, in our fellowship, Hein would be this unforgettable presence, not in what he would say, but in the peace that he would bring, that he would just be in that space. And he wasn't a wallflower, but unforgettable. And that is maybe a banner that I want to put over this divine service. Unforgettable. And that he will never be forgotten, that what he has done will never be forgotten, that who he is and his family and what he's put in will never be forgotten. There is a short obituary that has been shared, a life history, and I'd like to just share that with the congregation. If you see any falseness here, please put up your hand and then we'll take your feedback from the floor. Heinrich Williams passed away peacefully on Monday the 13th of February 2023. That is true. Sometimes that is just said. Passed away peacefully. But this was the case. Hein was surrounded by his family. He was surrounded by singing. He was surrounded by prayer. It was peaceful. And I don't want to interrupt every sentence, but that was absolutely true. Hein passed away peacefully on Monday the 13th of February after a gradual decline in his health. He was surrounded and supported by his loving family and caregivers during the last days of his life. Heinrich was born in Alsace River on the 2nd of December 1983. Hein's childhood and schooling was spent in Klerksdorp. This is where he considered his hometown. He was proud of this, and to the core, he was a Klerksdorper. I didn't know that existed until I read this. And he took his children there just a short while ago. He took his family there to show them where he's from. After completing high school, Heinrich joined the Air Force and worked as a technical administrator. Heinrich met his wife, Sally Ann, on deployment in Argentina. Nochal. It doesn't say Nochal here, but Nochal. The relationship blossomed and they got engaged in Paris in May 2011. That's Paris with an I, not a Y, so don't get confused with the Klerksdorp and the... They then exchanged marriage vows on the 21st of January 2012. The marriage was blessed with three daughters, Heidi, Lydia, and Ezra. In January 2020 to February 2021, Heinrich had the pleasure of being a stay-at-home dad to Heidi and Lydia at the time. These moments were greatly cherished by Heinrich. He then furthered his career at Eastern Cape Aviation and, due to ill health, was medically boarded in January 2023. Heinrich was a spiritually grounded, humble person who had a great sense of humor. When adversity struck, he would be the most calm. He would take a step back and always stood strong. He delighted us by imparting his great knowledge of the Bible and leaves a great spiritual legacy that will never cease in any of our hearts, minds, and lives. Hein is survived by his wife, Sally Ann, 3 daughters, grandfather, mother, father, and 3 siblings. A beautiful testament, a simple testament, will you allow me to say a clean testament? A clean bill of health. We were chatting in preparation, and one of the comments that were made was, you know, when we come together from different denominations, then often maybe what is the case is we compare differences. And we say, what don't you learn? What don't ons? And what don't you learn? And one of the comments was that when anybody was in conversation with Heinrich around those topics, he would bring it down to simple, spiritual, biblical principles. What a wonderful lesson for us all, that we get caught up in stuff. We get caught up in the color of a situation where certain things are just plain. God's love is plain. It is simple. It is free. And it is what we come to celebrate. What a beautiful witness of that. Uncomplicated. It's how we come to this funeral divine service today. In a way that's uncomplicated. It's just love. It's love for Heinrich. It's love for the family. It's care. It's support. It's belief in the fact that there is a beautiful place that is prepared for us. A feature of the opening hymn and also what the choir sang was home. We heard the word home over and over and over again. Home. And whenever we conduct funeral divine services, I think of that concept. And think that home is a beautiful place to reference when you say, when you're away from somewhere, and they say, where are you on your way to? You say, I'm going home. Then it brings up a wonderful feeling. Because I didn't have to describe home to us. We know it. We understand it. And so that is where Hein has gone. He has gone home, and you would have been happy to realize that. You would have been comforted to realize that. We leave things behind, but that there is this beautiful sense of home, and that we know that we are together in Christ too. So we cannot now connect in the way that we have been programmed and understand connection to be, but that there is an opportunity now for a higher connection through our belief, through what God has made possible in our life. So brothers and sisters, we come and we want to receive a word also, because we are in the house of God, and a word has been prepared, and that word says out of Proverbs, maybe I'll read it again, Proverbs 3, verse 3 and 4. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Bind them around your neck, write them on the tablet of your heart, and so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man. And I was very happy is not the word, but it was a good feeling when Noel again was in the sacristy, and we shared with him, this is the word that will be used for the divine service, and he said, that was Hein. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Mercy and truth did not forsake him in his life, in his approach, in his orientation, in his responses. Mercy and truth did not forsake him. And again, brothers and sisters, friends, guests, you would have examples of this. When he showed mercy, you would have examples of when he shared truth, and maybe it wasn't easy to hear, and maybe it wasn't comfortable, because maybe we wanted blood, but he said, but you must be merciful. Maybe we wanted to spin things a little bit, but he said, no, but here's truth. I'm not trying to say he was perfect, Sally Ann, because if you were to give us a testimony, then you would have some other examples. No one is perfect, but to have that aspiration, to be that person, for that to be at your core, that your ambition is towards mercy and your ambition is towards truth. A beautiful example of that. And then scripture says to us that what we must do is we must bind it around our neck and write it on the tablet of our heart so that it becomes part of us. That it's not a feature, that it's not something that we pull out when we think it's appropriate, but it becomes part of who we are. It becomes part of our identity, that we are merciful, that we are truthful, that this is a part of our character, our DNA, as Christians, as believers. And then there's the effect of taking on that identity. The effect is that we find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man. So maybe that the part of high esteem in the sight of man, maybe that doesn't always happen. Maybe that doesn't happen in our lifetime. Maybe we never hear that, we never get that acknowledgement. But that the aspiration, brothers and sisters, for us, the spiritual ambition that we have, is to find esteem in the sight of God, to find favor, to find grace in the sight of God. And certainly that is the case with Hein. Certainly that is the case with his family, with what he has seeded into his family, that he finds a beautiful place, high esteem with God our Father now, where he finds himself, home. And that we come, brothers and sisters, and we want to learn from this. And so one element and aspect that I would want to share with you as the family going forward, as the community that supports, and for all of us, is that we take this ambition of being merciful and being truthful, and we look at how Scripture guides us. And Scripture says that we must speak the truth in love. That we must not abuse this word. We must not say, but they said we must tell the truth, eh? And you need to hear some. Let me tell you. That we speak the truth in love. And that love is informed by care. That love is informed by the character of Jesus Christ. That when we speak the truth, it is to build. That when we speak the truth, it is to bring together. It is not to break, it is not to divide, but to bring together. So we want to take this word and we want to say, Lord, deepen it in my life. I want to be, I'm going to say this and I'm going to put it in context. I want to be like Hein. I want to have that type, I want to speak that type of truth. And again I say he was not perfect. Again I say it wasn't always flawless execution. But that ambition must be there. I want to speak the truth in love. And where we learned together from the mistakes that we made. Because you made mistakes earlier. Together. Where we learned together from those mistakes to say, Lord, what do you want to do with this now? What do you want to do with this mercy that you're placing into my life, on my heart? What do you want to do with this truth? How do I speak the truth in love? And how do I use that to bring your people together so that we can honor the legacy, so that we can show these little ones the way, so that we can show them faith, so that we can show them love, that we can show them truth, that we can show them mercy. This is what it is. So we come together, brothers and sisters, to celebrate a life. I can't get over this photograph. It is a beautiful, beautiful image of someone who recently had a haircut, had good dental health. Yellow was his color. I mean, all of these things. But I want to say also, brothers and sisters, that there are features of your life together, Sally, that demonstrate God's grace in such a specific way. I want to get this right, they had their first date in, I was told how to pronounce it, in Uruguay. Anybody else can say that, yeah? No? Their first date was in Uruguay, is how normal people say it. Sally says Uruguay. They got engaged in Paris, and she said, not in front of the Eiffel Tower, in front of the Notre Dame Cathedral. Now, let's not be confused, brothers and sisters. That is not God's grace. Exotic destinations and romantic little sidewalk cafes in Uruguay, oh, it's nice. But that's not God's grace. But the fact that God gives you those memories, that he says, this is what I have arranged for you. This is what love looks like for you. I've packaged it in such a specific way. And then God also arranged that you must settle in Peru. You know? So look, check God out, man. Look at God. But he puts it all together to say you can get caught up in this aspect in Paris and Uruguay, but life, that is what I give you. And then to be truthful and to be merciful and to remember those things, but not define yourself by it, but say, hey, because what is riches? There's three treasures there. What is riches? This group here is riches. Family, being together, this fellowship, having this place. So brothers and sisters, we leave here with that as our message. That out of Proverbs 3, we learn we want to be merciful and truthful. We want to write that into the tablets of our heart. That will deliver us to a place of high esteem. That we want to speak the truth with love. So that we can bring together communities, families. And we want to know that the Lord moves in a very particular way. That the Lord has moved in your life in a very particular way, Sally, and in the lives of the children. And that what lies ahead, we don't know. But that He has always provided, and He will continue to do that. That is our faith. That is our faith. And we want to surround you as we celebrate who God our Father is. As we celebrate this place that we understand as home here, but also what is prepared for us in the eternity. So I want to ask the choir to sing one more piece of music, and then we can move to concluding the events. Congregation, family, the moment has come. That moment that we see in the movies, where we return the body to the earth, and we hear those words, and it can be a very jolting moment. But again, I refer to what was said at the beginning of the divine service. Come, let us now as a congregation, let us not hold back from it. Let us not brace ourselves from it. But let us be part of this moment. That out of our faith, out of our knowledge of who God is, that we affirm this moment when the body is returned to the earth, when the soul is commended to the care of Jesus Christ. That this is our faith.
That this is our belief that we know and have understood and have experienced this to be true. So I ask that the congregation stand now, please, for the internment. I now return the mortal body to the earth with the words, earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Soul and spirit, however, I commend to the love of Jesus Christ, who shall guard over it until the resurrection to eternal life. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you receive us in love. You have received Lord Hein into your care, into a place of peace, of comfort, of love, of warmth, Lord, and of knowing, a wonderful sense of being home. And we, as those who remain behind, Lord, we celebrate this. We thank you for it. We thank you that you are who you are to us, Lord. We want to ask that you stand with this family, that you stand with this community of love and care, and that together, Lord, we may hold on to each other, that we may hold on to your teaching, your word, that we may hold on to the fellowship, Lord, the church of Christ, that we look there and draw the strength which is available to us, and that we know, Lord, we are together in Christ. That these are not empty words, that it is not a sentiment that is there to fool or to trick us, but that we are able to rise, Lord, now to that level of understanding, that there is a great congregation that you have gathered, a great congregation of believers, of followers, of those who praise, and we are part of this together now, Lord. Please give us that experience, give Sally and the girls, give them that experience of connection, Lord. Be with them, guide them, give them wisdom. When they cry, Lord, give them comfort. Not that they stop crying, but that it may serve as a wonderful sense of knowing, a wonderful sense of love, Lord, that you stand above all things, that you have moved in their life and touched them, but that this love, Lord, is never in question. Please be with us now. Be with the family. Allow for them to feel this wonderful movement of your spirit. Allow that we may show mercy and truth, that we may speak the truth in love, that we may take the examples and the lessons, Lord, out of Hein's life, and that we may apply it and bring it to life in new ways, in unexpected ways, and that we celebrate him, that we celebrate his legacy, and that they never forget, Lord, who he is, that through us he lives, and that there is a wonderful aroma, Lord, of love, of memory, of legacy that is left wherever it is that his name is spoken. We pray and ask for all of this, Lord. We place it before you in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the comforting fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and remain with us all. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, the family wishes to express their thanks. I'll read it. We as the Williams family would like to express our gratitude and thanks for all the support during this difficult time in our lives. Thank you for your contributions as well as your condolences. We especially want to thank the medical personnel at 2 Military Hospital, Kales River Netcare and N1 City Netcare for their professionalism, dedication, and commitment to the excellent medical care provided to Heinrich. Thank you to the undertaker for the sterling service, the caterers, and to each and every one who effortlessly volunteered their time to assist us during this period. We as the family would like to extend an invitation to join us in fellowship after this divine service in the hall adjacent to this building, which is to the right of this building. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All I heard was caterers. So the hall is just next door. Thank you, Tally and the family, for including us in that. We'll sing together, brothers and sisters, to close the divine service, hymn number 40, Great is Thy Faithfulness. We'll sing one verse. Brothers and sisters, an appropriate end. The Lord is faithful, Sally. The Lord is faithful. So we can move over now, but Sally and the family will come to the front, and if you'd like to wish them and share condolences, please feel free to spend a brief moment with them and then move over for some fellowship on the side. Okay, thank you very much, everyone.
Give of your best to Lord.